Well, good Monday morning. Actually, it's Sunday evening, as I said, here to do my Monday devotional, but you won't see this until Monday, so I'm going to say good Monday. This is Pastor Hayton and the Lord Lights Devotional, and I am so happy again today to sit down with you for a few minutes and just talk about how we've got somebody that tries to influence our life that doesn't always tell the truth. And, of course, that somebody is Satan, known as the old devil. Bible says that the devil is a liar, and he is the father of all lies. And so you can't always listen to the devil because he always tells lies. And I've known some people that they'd rather climb a tree and tell a lie than to stand on the ground and tell the truth. You just knew as they were talking that they were exaggerating in such a way that it could be nothing but a lie. But Satan, he's always trying to feed us information that is not true. I think a lot of times we look back in the Garden of Eden, and he told Eve when he was talking to her about the forbidden fruit, he said, "Now did God say that you shouldn't eat of that tree?" Well, yeah, because God said in the day that we ate of the forbidden fruit, we're going to die. Well, the first lie that Satan fed, "Oh, ye surely will not die. Go ahead and eat of that fruit. It looks good to the eye. So go ahead. I'm sure it's a taste as good as it looks, and you won't die." Well, ever since then, Satan's been deceiving, lying to the people of God. Now, the devil lies to deceive us. He lies to get us to go astray. The devil lies sometimes to discourage us. I certainly have mentioned in the last few broadcast or devotionals that I've made that I don't want to be deceived in these days. And yet Satan is a great deceiver. And where God's word is rather plain and firm, Satan would have us to believe that God really doesn't mean what he says. And he would tell us the lie that God really doesn't mean that. "Oh, that's not what the Bible really means. You've been taught all wrong. You're reading it wrong. That isn't for this day and time." On and on, the way Satan talks to us, sometimes it's just one big lie. And he can deceive us into believing the truth. And it gets so bad that Jesus said the time would come that men would be given over to a reprobate mind where they would actually believe a lie and be damned. And I think as much as what Satan is lying and trying to deceive the church and the Christian today, it's that I wonder sometimes if we haven't reached that place where we really believe the lie of Satan, that it really doesn't matter what we do, doesn't matter what we believe. Satan is a liar. And I know that I don't want to listen to Satan because he's out to deceive me. And then Satan's out to discourage us. I worked hard on church today. I knew it's a holiday weekend, and I knew that, there were going to be some people gone over the holiday weekend, other activities and things like that. And the devil told me, he said, "You're not going to have anybody at church Sunday. We're not going to have a good day at all." And I listened to the devil and I got a little bit discouraged. "Well, Lord, I've got a good sermon, Lord, and it don't look like nobody's going to be there to hear it." But you know, the devil told me that lie to try to discourage me and to believe that nobody was going to be there to hear my sermon. Well, the devil is a liar. We didn't have as many people as we sometimes do. There were a good many people that were away, and some of our key people that we lean on rather heavily for leadership in worship. But all in all, it was a good day. Had a nice, lovely congregation. Had a wonderful time of fellowship at the noon meal. Came back to church Sunday night and enjoyed Sunday night service. See, the devil tried to discourage me by saying there wasn't going to be anybody in church. So the devil is a liar, and he will lie to deceive you. He will lie to discourage you. Don't listen to him. Just call him out. Tell him he's a liar and you're not going to pay any attention to the lie that he gives. Heavenly Father, your word has declared that the devil is a liar. We don't want to believe his lies, to be deceived nor discouraged. So help us, Lord, to believe the truth, to trust the truth, put our faith and our trust in God. Bless us throughout this day and on down throughout another week of life. We want to pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, thanks for letting me share that, and I'll see you tomorrow on the Lord Lights Devotional here with Pastor Hayton. Have a happy Labor Day. Goodbye.